Hey, today we have played a little bit of Blood Scent and a little bit of Overwhelming Hunger. And both decks are basically sort of the same, and both are like pretty decent. They actually can win games if you pilot them correctly. I have made a lot of mistakes during my games, but it's actually pretty cool and pretty fun to play, and it's not that bad. So this deck is pretty standard. I will show you also the second one. So the plan is to play your bronzes with a little bit of Thrive and a lot of Bleed, and put a Gherkin to have some engine on the board. Same with Necuret. And also you have a package of big golds with Ozreal, like Yikhern and Goliath. And the standard vampire cards like Protofledger, Orianna that you can hide behind the Cave Troll and win like this. And of course Adastriga, Queen of the Night, Geld and Beast, all of the like value cards and also engines. Beast and Orianna you can hide behind the Cave Troll, and that's basically your win condition for round 3. You have here Caretaker if you encounter a lot of poison, so you can clear all of the big boys and big girls. And Naglfar helps you thin the deck. So this is pretty standard bleed vampire deck. It's actually pretty interesting that this deck is always there. It's always fine. CD Projekt like managed to balance it to the probably the perfect stance. Like it's never now in the meta, but it's also never bad to play. Even like I think 2 seasons ago, when no one remembered about this deck, it managed to got into the tournament and won few games, and win few games. So this deck is actually pretty fine. If you want something different for monsters, you can play it. So if you want to play Overwhelming Hunger, you can play a little bit differently. So you change the leader. You can get rid of a Caretaker, you can get rid of some bronzes, maybe Ada and Protofledger, and you add cards like Crimson Curse, Whispers, Tribute and Parasite to get these cards, and also Deathlap for your leader ability. As you can see, the provision is not yet here, but this is roughly what it should look like. You can like cut, I don't know, Goliath for example, and and maybe Inglerit's Wrath, and then add few 5 provision cards, and you have a perfect bleed deck again, vampire deck, but with an extra finisher of Deathlap and Crimson Curse and Overwhelming Hunger. This deck also works. It's more interesting maybe to play because of the Crimson Curse and the positioning on vampires, but I actually think that the correct version of the blood deck is a tiny bit better. I will show you now one quick game of the a little bit meme version of the Blood Scent, because I have added a Crimson Curse to my Blood Scent deck, and I have to tell you, it doesn't work. For sure it's better to use Protofledger. So if you want to try the Blood Scent deck, don't play Crimson Curse, but play Protofledger. This card almost always is 10 for 9, and it's a vampire, so it's pretty good. I hope you will enjoy this deck. If you enjoyed it, please drop a like and drop a subscribe. And I will see you next time with another meme or dream deck. See you again. If we win a game, I'm gonna buy a new skin for him, because it looks pretty dope. Hidden cash, well, that's a surprise. That's something I didn't expect. This is good, this is good. This is good also. Oh, this hand is nice, but it's a little bit... yeah, fine. I actually like it. This hand looks pretty good. But this deck might struggle with Hidden Cash. Like Imlarid Wrath is good sometimes. Maybe I should add Portal to this deck for Garkane. These are 5 provision cards. So I would have to cut Bruxas. Pretty much only Bruxas. I like this idea. This is not yet very good. Ah, come on. We'll help one. Now I cannot play anything. Oh, maybe I should have. I don't have any movement, right? But I can thin a little bit. Like, I cannot win this round. Oh, maybe. With Goliath and T-Kern. I can play both. And he's using all of his tools. 3 ounces of Optimumator, a drop of Mercury solution. I can use Seekern. I can even use Imlarid, but this is a little bit annoying. But he failed Adalbertus. He failed it. So this is good for us. Well, the fail of the opponent is always a good thing, right? My eyes are closing. I had such a terrible day at work today. Is he gonna pass? Oh no, come on. He never passed. Your deepest, darkest dreams, I can make them real. I'm spending a lot of golds, but the thing about this deck is that, like, all of these cards are good, pretty much. That's a good thing about, like, Monster Bleed. Okay. I'm gonna still play Ikern. We share the profits, not the work. Because we want him for the last round in graveyard, he can kill it, I don't care. I'm gonna pass after this. And he failed the ship again. He already failed it twice. It's funny. By failed, I mean that he's not getting full value from Kiki or Queen. Imlarid Wrath is pretty nice, but I don't really have a target for it. I can push him because I like round 3. And this way he doesn't get a point from Sliced Actress because it was a spell. And I want to keep the Bloodsend charges for Orianna. However, he has a lot of poison. He needs to play something. He needs to spend some coins. I'm still gonna bleed him. I don't even need to spend a charge, right? Yeah. This is pretty good. And I still have my big boys for round 3. You see? He's using so many resources. It looks like I'm using a lot of resources as well, but it's actually not really true. We can pass this. He doesn't have Albertus, which is amazing against me because I bleed everything. He doesn't have his removal and he doesn't have his steal. I'm pretty fine with it. Oh, I have beast. Oof. That's a good hand. Well, Cave Troll is not very useful in this matchup. Caretaker would be nice. But I need something to play now. Cave Troll is good with Orianna, and Orianna is good with the Beast, because she should grow faster. Naglafar is great, this is also good. Larva is also good, but we can get something better. This is pretty good, but because it buffs Orianna as well. I like it. I'm gonna start with Cave Troll. So I wanna play Orianna fast, but I also want to make Nekurat work. But I think we can lose the value from her deploy. This. Sure, maybe we should just start with this. And now I can play Beast as well. Well, I'm losing Bruxa value. But it's better. Beast is better than Bruxa. No, this gets like 1 point per turn. The Beast is getting 2. So I'm getting a lot of points, but I'm not sure if it's enough. I'm not sure if I want Naglafar next. I have Dominance, but it doesn't help. This also doesn't help. I only need corpses. Okay, we are getting a lot of points. But I'm not sure. He still has Savola, Tinboy and Madame. Okay? He doesn't have one of these three. He's getting sheep as well. Okay. So I can kill this and get 8 points, yes? 6 points. This is 6 points, right? Because I'm gonna kill this, so I lose 2 points, but I'm gonna get 8. So this is more. Do we play here in case of Tin Boy? I like it here. That's a late soul. It's amazing because he's still gonna go to 10. No, maybe not 10 because of the horde. To 8, but still very good. I can't. Okay. What he has there? He doesn't have. He cannot go with Tin Boy. Savola. It's not enough points, right? Or is it? Oh yeah! Is it a new meta breaker? Vampire deck? Easy hidden cash victory.